Good morning, how are you?
I'm fine. So, how have you been spending the quarantine?
A lot of camping recently, which is great. So I think I'm enjoying that we're finally able to kind of walk outside a little bit more, but it's been interesting. It's been a very reflecting time, and keeping myself entertained has been entertaining in itself.
I'll bet. Well, you were on the Originals and All Americans, so I should say welcome back to the CW. Does it matter for an artist like yourself, an actor slash actress, where your projects air? Is there a different culture, a different vibe, or is it you just concerned with the work and the execution?
That's a good question. To be honest with you, I think a lot of it's depending on the subject matter and the audience. I think at the end of the day, I'm so grateful that the show is now on CW. I think it's a great way for more people to get to watch the show. It was originally with CBS All Access, and I had such a blast with them and getting to shoot it with them. And so the fact that we now have a new home with CW, where I've found a home over the years, I'm so excited for CW's audience to get to watch it. I think they're gonna really, really love it.
Well, tell us about your character, Kayla.
Sure. I play Kayla Powell. She is a girl who is mad at the world. She just lost her mom, and her dad uproots her from California to New York to live with their grandmother. And she's not happy about it. She's leaving kind of the only bit of home that she has left. And so she's starting a new life in a new school. And she kind of finds every way possible to get herself into trouble and to make friends that are not good for her, and kind of rediscover who she is and kind of what she wants. And I think it's a really good coming of age story for her. And I think there's also a lot of mischief and sexy drama, and it's a lot of fun.
Sounds like it. So, how much of this character is yourself? I know to a certain degree, some people, more or less, when they are absorbing a character to become that thing, that they use a certain percentage of their own life. Do you do that, or is this all just, this is all somebody else?
I feel like I've answered this question differently in the past, but I think at the end of the day, every character has to be a little bit of yourself, because it is your physical body who's embodying a character. So I think for me, there's little bits and of qualities to her, even if it's just like her putting her hair behind her ear at a certain point. I may do that naturally in a moment.
You just
So
did.
I just did. I just did. I think that was probably as I was talking, I was thinking through it. I hope I'm not as sassy as she is. That would be. I think there's components to her that I definitely elevate of myself if I'm angry or something. But I think a lot of it, I also try to put myself in a character's shoes who's experiencing what she's gone through. So, like what someone I haven't just lost my mom. Friends of mine have lost their parents, and I know what they've gone through. Not that I've tried to pull from their experience, but I know what that pain looks like. And when you care about people around you too, you feel their pain, and that's it. So I think there's a lot of truth in the characters that I like to play, and I'm trying to help portray that.
Are you working on anything else right now, or is this your focus?
This is my focus at the moment. I think projects are really interesting that are being currently shot, but I haven't seen too many of them. So I'm really curious to see kind of how our industry continues to kind of put projects out, and there is a lot to come. So I'm looking forward to that. I'm hopeful. I'm excited, and definitely so stoked for everyone to get to see my story.
Well, we're thrilled you're part of our family here on the CW. Thank you so much for your time, for your perspective as well. Danielle Campbell, appreciate it.
Hi guys, thank you.
All right, take care. Be safe. Stay